Kunji Fukfu translates into taming the tiger in an H-shaped footwork pattern. The character Kung is the noun for the verb character Kung in Kung Fu. It means work. In this context, however, its usage refers to the shape of the written character, which is similar to an H turned on its side. This shape best describes the footwork pattern of the form. Kunji Fukfu is commonly believed to be the oldest Hungar form still in existence, created by Hung Hae-gwan 7 generations ago. Some legends attribute the name Hungar as a derivation of Hung Hae-gwan. It is more credible that the name derives from Hung Swan, which refers to the Chinese opera house boats where the Shaolin monk Ji Simsumsi covertly taught revolutionaries Kung Fu after escaping the destruction of the Fukien Shaolin Temple. Hungar is well suited for the practice on boats. The deep stances lend themselves to an unstable boat deck, and the short hand techniques are most useful in the cramped quarters of a boat cabin or galley. Hung Hae-gwan was a student of Ji Simsumsi. Hung was a tea merchant by trade, and his skill in Kung Fu won him the name the Southern Fist. Kunji is traditionally the first form taught to the student of Hungar. It contains many of the basic techniques characteristic to this system of combat. The Kyusao, or bridge hand, is one of the most recognizable techniques of Hungar. In the Kyusao, the index finger is extended at a 90 degree angle from the forearm. The three remaining fingers curl in tightly, leaving no gaps, and the thumb curls down and hooks at the joint. Kunji, like most southern forms, is a long form, stressing endurance and sustained power. Many sequences will be repeated in left-right mirror image to train avid dexterity. This form will be taught in 20 lessons. Each lesson will begin with footwork, proceed to hand techniques, and finish with applications. Many of the hand techniques in this form are practiced in doubles, where the same technique is performed with both hands simultaneously and symmetrically. Doubles allow for more challenging yet economical practice. These techniques are applied in single. Start at attention, with your legs strong and straight and your spine erect. This form begins with arm techniques, so initially your footwork is stationary. Step forward into a right twist stance. Then forward into a left cat stance. Step backward into a right twist stance. Then backward to standing straight again. Starting with your fingertips, curl your fist up until your forearms are horizontal. Open your palms and extend your arms forward with your fingertips pointed up. Turn your palms in and curl your fist in making your forearms parallel. Bring your fist to your ears. with elbows out, then extend your arms to the sides in Q-sal. Three times, keeping your wrist at shoulder level. Bring your palms by your ears, block down, then jab. Then drop your forearms down, fingers up and thumbs out. Bring your left tiger claw to your right side, fist and salute. Bring your fist in, elbows up, then circle them back to your sides. In this single block down, the fingertips are pulled back and the block is made with the palm. The jab slides up the arm into the throat. Move your feet, heel, toe, heel, toe, sinking down into the horse stance. Double block down with fingertips pointed toward each other. Bring your palms in together and extend fingertips up and thumbs forward. Extend your forearms forward in the Q-sal three times. Your horse stance must remain stable, maintaining the same low height for the duration of this lesson. Double block up, pull down, and double palm strike with your palms. Drop your forearms down, finger up, thumbs forward, double high block with the palms, double flank block, cross your fist and back fist block. Bring your fist to your sides. Make sure that your feet are parallel and flat on the floor. Following a block up, the wrist is flipped over to pull down, then this push rides the arm up to the throat. In this application of the high block with palms in, flank block, and back fist block, the final block is made with the alternate hand. This double technique is broken down into a single alternating hand application instead of a same hand application. Step out into a right cat stance, then back into a left bow. Block and kick with your right toe and land in a horse, quickly shifting to a right bow. Move your right foot, heel, toe, then pivot into a left cat stance. Step forward into a left bow and arrow, pivot on your left leg, and into a left twist stance. Step forward into a right bow and arrow, shift the horse, then back to a right bow, then to a horse stance again. Keep your fist at your sides, then block with your left forearm with your right fingers pointing at your left shoulder. Keep your fist at your sides, then block with your left forearm with your right fingers pointing at your left shoulder. Block up to the side with your left forearm, then block straight up. Chop diagonally down with your left, then block up and to the side with your left foot. Block your left flank, then push with your left palm. Strike your left elbow, then left jab. Left flank block and left push. Left low back fist to the center, then left back fist to the side. Return your fist to your side. this block and kick, the block deviates the path of the opponent's attack just enough to get inside to strike. The forearm block controls the opponent's fist with the right hand. The second block crosses the opponent's arm up to him at a disadvantage. Retreating into twist stance provides the distance for the flank block and the windup for this push. Lunging into the bow stance places all the body weight into the strike of the opponent's throat. Step out into a left cat stance, then back into a right bow. Block and kick with your left toe and land in a horse, quickly shifting to a bow. With your left foot, heel, toe, then pivot into a right cat stance, step forward into a right bow, pivot on your right leg into a right twist stance, then step forward into a left bow, shift to a horse, then back to a left bow, then to a horse stance. Keep your fist at your side, then block your right forearm with your left fingers pointing out at your left shoulder. Chop diagonally down with your right, then block up and to the side with your left. Block your right flank, then push with your right palm. Strike with your right elbow, then right jab. Right flank block and right push. Right low back fist to center, then right back fist to the side. Return your right fist to your side. Step out into a right cat stance, then lunge forward into a right bow and arrow stance. Shift back to a right cat stance, then lunge forward into a right bow again. Block across your head with your right hand, strike with double tiger claws, left, then right, pull. With both your hands to level of your waist. Repeat the claw and pull. On the third claw, pull down to a low center while shifting into a cat stance. Lunge forward and claw again. Here, the first right claw is used to block and control the opponent's wrist. After the face rake, the left claw pulls from the elbow. The second right claw moves up to the elbow and the left claw rakes again. In the low claw, the ankle and knee are grabbed, and this strike is aimed at the throat and the navel. Shift to a left bow, then back to a left cat. Lunge forward into a left bow and arrow stance. Shift back to a left cat stance, then lunge forward into a left bow again. Shift to a left twist stance. Grab horizontally with both hands, ending with both fists at your left shoulder. Block cross your head with your left hand, strike with double tiger claws, right, then left, and pull with both of your hands to your right at your waist level. Repeat the claw and pull. On the third claw, pull down to the center while shifting into a cat stance. Lunge and claw again, grab horizontally with both hands twice, ending with both fists at your right shoulder, then by your left shoulder. This horizontal grab controls the wrist while pinching the muscles of the forearm. This block crosses the opponent's arms, then the claw controls the elbow and strikes to the throat. step through a horse stance into a right bow. Shift back to a right cat stance, then lunge forward to a right bow. Repeat this footwork twice. After the third lunge into a bow, shift back into a horse stance, then forward to a right bow. Shift back to a right cat, then forward to a horse, then shift right to a bow. Double block down. Block high with your left palm, then your right. Slap your left forearm, right block up, then chop diagonally. Block high and right chop, double grab with your left fist and double back fist. Double flank block, then double jab. Double high block, then double push. Double grab with your left fist up, double back fist to your side, then left hook punch and right uppercut. This first application shows the entire initial blocking sequence of lesson 7. Note that in the first kick block, both palms are on the shin as opposed to fingertips pointing towards each other. In application, the double back fist is not held symmetrically. Instead, one of the fists strikes to the neck and the other to the elbow. In this jab, instead of holding both hands together, the left is used to smother the opponent's fist. Here is an example of a double block and a double push that is applied exactly as in the form instead of a single action. When the left hook is blocked, it immediately changes into a maneuver to pull down the opponent's fist to make an opening for the uppercut. Step diagonally into a right bow. Then diagonally to a left. Then to a right. Then diagonally to left. Bring your right foot up to your left foot. Pivot to face back and stand up straight. Grab with your right and strike with your left forearm. Grab with your left and strike with your right forearm. Repeat. Right grab, left strike, and then left grab, right strike. Bring your fist in, elbows up, and circle them to your sides. This forearm strike relies on the backhand maintaining its grip and weakness of the elbow. It attacks from the outside, crossing the opponent's arms, making it difficult to backhand. Move your feet, heel, toe, heel, toe, sinking into the horse stance. Set your horse stance. The horse stance must remain stable at all times while performing these hand techniques. Step into a left cat stance. Then lunge forward into a left bow, step diagonally back into a right bow, then back into a left bow. Double block down, with fingertips pointing each other, bring your palms together and extend fingertips up and thumbs forward. Extend your forearms forward in the Q-sal 3 times. Double block up, down, and double jab. High block, double cross block, and double outside back fist block, and chamber in. Bring your fist to your sides, both palms to your left side, then push. Grab with your right and strike with your left forearm, right high block, then left chop with your right hand by the elbow. In this application, all the hand techniques are done to one side, without the stance turning. These first two techniques attempt to cross up the opponent's arms. His final chop rides up the opponent's shoulder to his neck. Pivot into a right cat stance, then lunge forward into a right bow. Step diagonally back into a left bow. Then diagonally back into a right bow. Step out into a left bow, then forward into a right bow. Sweep left to end in a low bow. Bring both palms to your right side, then double push. Grab with your left and strike with your right forearm, high block, back step, and double chop. Low sweep, step forward, double high block, around low sweep into a double hook. This double low block catches the kick at the knee and the ankle, then circles forward to the takedown. In this second application, the opponent escapes the takedown by pivoting with the block. The follow-through sweep attacks at the knee with the hook strike. Bring your left foot to your right and kick with your right toe. Jump and spin around into a horse stance. Shift to a left bow. Shift back to a left cat. Forward into a left bow. Repeat this footwork twice. After the third lunge into a bow, shift back into a horse, then forward to a left bow. Shift back to the left cat, then forward to the horse, into the left bow. Shift back to a horse, then forward to the left bow. Bring both fists to your side. Double block down. Right high block, left. Left slap block, up, down chop, forward block and chop with the right hand extended, pull, double back fist. Flank block, double jab, pull open, double palm strike. Pull, the double side block, hook punch, right pull and a left uppercut, Q-sal bridge hand block into a right flat punch. Shift to a horse stance, then to a right bow. Pivot to a left crane stance, then step forward into a horse, then forward again into a horse. Shift to a right cat, to a forward. Back step and strike with your right elbow. Step in and over with your left elbow. Up, down block with the back fist, around to a swing down chop. In, chamber at the side into a double palm strike. After blocking the punch, step in with the right and follow in with the left elbow strike. The crane stance is an evasion for a leg sweep. Grab and follow around with a chop. Bring your left foot to your right, then transition from a horse to a bow. Right unicorn step, horse to a bow. Left unicorn step, horse to a bow. Horse to a bow, right horse to a bow, back step and horse into a bow, back step to the other corner, horse to a bow again. High left block into a short punch, unicorn step circles around, double palm strikes. These techniques repeat for both sides. High block, center punch, high block, center punch, low block, center punch, and low block, center punch to the back, and again to the front. The block in this unicorn step counters a kick, then a punch, each crossing the opponent's limbs up. These twist stands sneak in so that the double paw strike can start at a very close distance. Pivot into a horse, then left bow, then forward to a right horse, then forward to a bow, then left bow, back step into a bow stance, then right heel kick, pivoting around into a horse stance. Chop left, then right punch. Grab at the wrist, sink in into the elbow strike, low groin strike into a back fist. Back step around to a double block into the chop, grabbing the other opponent's strike into the heel kick. After your attacking fist is grabbed, break the grab, step in with the right elbow, low groin strike, and follow through with the back fist. The circle block is applied from right down to left into the left palm strike. After your attacking chop is blocked, pivot the elbow around to intercept the opponent's counter punch, then grab and pull the kick to the armpit. Shift to a left reverse low bow, then forward. Shift to right reverse bow, then step backward into a right twist, then wind into the horse. Left low block, then two finger jab to the eye, pull, backhand block, cross over low block, turn, and chamber. This low block covers a kick to the groin area. Then the right finger jab will poke directly into the eyes and then pull down. Both high and low blocks are made with the same hand. The twist stance opens the distance between fighters and breaks off the immediate threat. Jump up and step forward to a bow stance. Right leg out horse into a bow, left out horse into a bow. Right leg forward to a bow, into a cat stance, forward bow stance, step left to right, toe kick, jump, and landing in a horse stance. Swing your fist. Right front to left rear, then high block and left palm strike, low block, scoop grab, pull in, and double push throw. Toe kick, and landing in the horse stance. This jump is to elude a sweep. The left arm will block a punch while the arm or the right hand swings up into the arm area. The right hand outward blocks while the left penetrates into the solar plex area. This left palm is a leg grab and throw. Step back into a left bow. with the right seven star stance, foot turned inward and step backward into the left bow, shift to a right bow, and step into the left bow. Left low block, grab and pull. Right punch, then retract, grab left and right, then pull left. Pull right as you sweep, then push back to center, strike with double tiger claws, right block and left strike, then block and right strike. The left low block and left grab and pull sets the opponent up for the right punch. Note that the stance change is what gives the punch power. The opponent's grab is grabbed along with his flank. The opponent is then pulled off balance. As he tries to regain balance, he falls victim to follow up a sweep. This sequence is a continuation of the last application. The opponent evades the sweep by picking up his leg only to fall prey to an arm lock and back step locking his knee. Here is the application of the tiger claw technique. The first claw blocks, the second rakes the face. Step forward into a right twist stance. Unwind into a horse, then left bow. Step forward to a right cat, then to a right bow. Double dragon claw, Q-style block into a punch, low block, high, soak around, pull and punch. These dragon claws and Q-style serve as retreating blocks. This footwork sets up the counter punch. Four attacks are blocked with one circular arm technique. The final change in direction of your left hand with the grab opens up the opponent's flank. Step to a left cat, then to a left bow. Into a right cat, into a right bow. Into a left cat, into a left bow. With your left arm, circle block your flank, head, flank, then grab and punch with your right. Block to your right with both palms, then palm strike, left hand on top, then repeat the reverse. Step forward through a horse into a right bow, backward to a right cat, forward to a right bow. Bring your feet together, then through the horse to a left bow. Step back into left cat and circle back step, feet together at attention position. Double low blocks, then hook punch, pull and jab. Low block, forward left claw, bring it in, Q-style block, right punch, retract, salute, in, and chamber. The left side of this double block serves as a preparation for the hook punch. This panther fist is aimed directly at the eyes. Here is another application of the tiger claws. This block is with a retreat so it covers a kick. This claw rakes the sternum. Again, Sifu Lam performs the entire set. Because of the composition of this set, different camera angles were used to provide the best view of each lesson. Since there is a lot of diagonal footwork, use this sequence to be sure that you are aligned correctly with your point of origin. Every set begins and ends at the same position on the floor. If you are ending up facing the wrong direction, some correction must be made. When practicing this set, do not rush the movements. Students often become preoccupied with a quick application and recite the movements too quickly. Keep in mind that these exercises are practiced with isometric and/or dynamic tension. Gungji Fukfu is unique in Hungar for opening the set with an exercise sequence. Other sets begin with the salute first. By performing these movements too fast, students deny themselves the benefits of a good forearm workout.